Hi, how you doing?
Charged up, huh?
Not really. I'm in Subway with everything still charging on the wall. What's going on? Five. Which one? And the rest of the show?
That's the Cardinals hat. It's Mike Brown Sr.
Oh, okay. That's Mike Brown's dad. Everybody getting a lot of love from the community. Definitely see that. This is a very beautiful scene. I'm sorry. My name is Jessica. Everybody calls me Bella by my little streaming name.
Okay.
I just want to say that I'm very sorry for that. Sorry. Y'all don't understand that it keeps a young black man got shot and killed, and it keeps happening over and over again by the police department. So I have battery packs charging right now, and what I'm doing is just trying to film all I can, and I'll go back and get some more charge in a little bit. How y'all doing? Pretty good. Happy to see people coming out. You know what I mean? My name is Bella. Oh yeah. I think people are getting ready for this weekend.
There's a lot of them on the south side.
Oh yeah? Okay. So this is gonna be the vigil for a vigil right now tonight, right? Okay. I heard that they were doing one here too. I don't know, I think this whole protest has been a 61-day vigil. Like, people are in mourning and they're justifiably upset. It's righteous indignation. It's a number of different things, but at the bottom line is we're protesting, which definitely is not right. You know what I mean? This shit should not continue to happen. Like, my little baby is 1 year old. He in Subway right now with my friend, and it's like, how long before he put on a sweatshirt or some shit to be a threat to y'all? You know what I mean? He just a baby. You know what I mean? These are our babies. You just killing them.
Red fuck up.
Hey. You know, I love to see this, being an Oakland native. Black power. Got some of the Black Panther Party out here for sure. I'm good, brother. How you doing? So I just basically kind of wanted to give you guys a view of what's going on. Ichi would be out here, but HJ and he are inside of Subway, staying warm and watching the charges. So I just wanted to give you guys a view of what was going on, let you see that Mike Brown's family is out here. There are people from the Black Panther Party. There are members from the community. They're showing up in solidarity. With the South Side and the shooting, also because of Mike Brown and the ongoing waiting for an indictment or word of a lack of indictment, whatever, with Darren Wilson. You can see that mainstream media is on this side of the street for a change, actually trying to document something inside from riot porn, so you know. Hey,
Hi. How
you doing?
Good, how you doing?
I'm very good.
Get that covered?
Yeah, you know, I got to. I'm like, I see y'all a lot. Y'all was in Oakland all the time. So.
Oh, you do?
Uh-huh.
Are you from Oakland?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
You out here just for a minute, or are you
here? No, I'm here for a while.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Work.
I stayed a couple weeks, but we'll see.
Well, you know, I came out here 2 days after Michael Brown was killed, and I haven't left yet.
Yeah, so. You know, I came out here for about 5 days, and then I left and came back.
Uh-huh.
And now I'm here again.
Nice.
So we'll see when I go back.
So are you media?
Yeah.
I have vision problems.
There you
so.
Go. No problem. Oh, okay, wait, I'm sorry. My counselor had an issue like that. My name is Bellaeiko, and I'm an independent and freelance journalist.
Yeah.
So I do a lot of, I have my own website.
Yeah, what is it?
It's a
do you have a business card?
I do, but I left them at
the, okay.
I got to bring some more tonight. It's BE Media.
Hold on.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Okay, cool. It's a BE Media dot WEEBLY dot com.
Okay.
And I upload all the stuff that I shoot. It's live, everything. Uh-huh. And then I do it on Ustream, and then I download later and put on YouTube, and then I take it to my website. So,
great. Yeah. Because one thing is a spokesperson for what, the initiator of this, the co-initiator, Carl Dixon Cornell West. Always getting stuff, huh?
People are asking me if I'm in St. Louis or if I'm in Oakland, so I was like, well, that'd be a good sign.
Yes, yes. Yeah, right, that's a famous sign. Anyway, I was going to encourage you to one of the co-founders of Cornell is Carl Dixon, spokesperson for the Revolutionary Comedy Party, is coming this weekend. And
okay.
I'd like to get him to get his what he has to say out. But he was here and got arrested in the first week defying the curfew. But, you know, it's also kind of part of this national movement, which is really aimed at, like, getting rid of this whole thing, but also building up strength for the end of this whole system. Mass incarceration, global epidemic rape against women, drone terror, and the endless wars of empire. He's representing a strategy and a vision of how to do it. Calling on people, let's get recruited now and get rid of this system. And moments like this, it's been a wake-up call.
Yeah,
you know, something is changing. When think about this. When Von Derrick Myers, when he was killed last night, immediately, we were over here. Immediately, a bunch of you got in their cars and went there, right?
I was here with them.
Oh, you were? You were there?
We went over there.
Okay, well, and so both that, in other words, this was not going to go down, you know, the way it normally does in this country. And then further, as we were marching, a lot of people came out of that neighborhood, including people of different nationalities, you know, and things like that. And it was kind of like, it's a sign of what has changed in terms of people not putting up with this shit.
Well, and I can appreciate that, finally. You know, I'm glad it was a wake-up call for people that that have needed it, but I'm like, it's still a lot of people who are definitely asleep, you know what I mean?
I know.
Still working on it, but I like to see, like, when you see these young black youth organizing and standing in the street and refusing to be intimidated and educating themselves about their rights, I mean, there's something that's like, I want to say addictive is the word. You know what I mean? Like, it infects you. You know what I mean? Because it's something you don't see all the time.
Right.
And, I mean, but that's also an image that's very dangerous to this system. Yeah. You know what I mean? And so you can see why it's taken a lot of bashing of mainstream media to even get them to move their cars from the police parking lot. And who knows if that's a thing that the police have made them do or something that they've done on their own accord at this point. You know what I mean? So
we have to think of how much this system has invested in this demonization of the youth over the last couple decades.
Yeah.
So much in this, the whole transformation of criminal justice, the first the war on drugs, now this mass incarceration. They put a lot into basically making people fear, you know, and putting a target on the back of every black and brown youth, but also making people accept that as somehow normal, you know. So that's what people have been up against, and it hasn't shattered it, but it is. Put some breaks in the wall.
Right.
You know.
Right. Well, thank you.
Yeah.
I'll definitely get the word about some stuff and check this out.
And I'll see you this weekend.
Yeah.
All right. Take care.
You too. All right. So where I'm going now? I'm only gonna be up for a little while, y'all, because I'm still charging up. Like I haven't charged everything. How you doing?
Came back.
Of course. I said I wasn't gonna be gone for long. I was here last night.
Live streaming right now.
Yeah. I was live streaming everything last night.
How you doing? All right, have a good one. Drive safe.
No, really. The world. It was like 30,000 people the last time I was here, so. Definitely want to get the word out that they don't, you know what I mean? They don't go out on the marches, they don't interview y'all and put the entire interview out. It's always a sound clip to fit their narrative. I'm here to get the people's voice out, you know what I mean? Like, that's what we need, you know what I mean? It's like we be criminalized in the media, they definitely be working with the police. You know what I'm saying? It's like we need people to get to know us as people so it can become more personal instead of them saying, look at CNN, the thugs on the news or some old weird shit like that. Like, why we can't be educated people? Is it just automatically because of the color of our skin?
They don't want you to be educated.
Right.
They don't want you to know. So they continue to do what they're doing right now and get away with it.
And they
want
to, exactly. How you doing? All right, y'all. Y'all see the scene. It's definitely not a lot of people. Hey, and I'm Rasta. I don't know if I'm going to the vigil on the south side. What's up, STL gal? Thank you for tuning in. I don't know if I'm going to the vigil on the south side just yet. I just wanted to come out and give you guys a live stream of what was happening here, because there are mainstream media vans over there, but you know, they don't necessarily tell the truth or show, so I just go ahead and show you. You know what I mean? There are children out here. This is a very calm crowd. There's nobody looking like they're gonna start breaking windows and rioting. There's not a massive police line. People are out here talking about stop police abuse. You know what I mean? They want justice for Mike Brown. This has to stop.
Right, I want justice for my cousin.
Oh, Mike Brown's your cousin?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You wanna tell us a little bit of something?
No, I just feel that everybody is, you know, just being there, just to witness Leslie going through what she's going through. You know, I feel it.
Yeah.
And it's been a while. It had been a while since I seen Mike. And we were supposed to have our family reunion. I hadn't seen Mike since he was eight.
Since he was what?
Eight. Yeah.
Wow.
And I've seen Leslie several times.
Uh huh.
You know, kids get older. You know, make plans or whatever. But I guess this is a part. They kind of, you know, my kids will never know they could have stayed. So it's a sad. It's a sad moment for everybody. You know, his grandfather, I am truly close to his grandfather. That's where he was at.
Okay.
You can see it in his eyes. He hurts every day.
Oh, I can only imagine. I mean, I came out here from Oakland in support of you guys and everything that's going on here. My one-year-old is in Subway right now. You know what I mean? Like, I'm very well aware of the fact that he could grow up one day and be treated the same way if we don't stand up. So I just offer my condolences to you, because I know that it won't bring him back. You know what I mean? But I'm here, and as much support and whatever I can offer to y'all, I definitely do. You know what I mean?
I know Leslie really appreciates this. The family appreciates all the support. I mean, not just locally, but around the world. All races are coming together to see the injustice. You know, the justice needs to be served. And everybody, we in this world, we call the land of the free, justice for all. That's not justice for all. Everybody doesn't get the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
When you want more for yourself, you go and you get it. But you're going to still stay at the lower, the bottom of that home. I'm a mother. I have three kids, one in college, the other two, one middle, one high school. And just to see my kids grow is a beautiful thing. My cousin won't get that opportunity anymore.
Right. Can I give you a hug? Would that be okay? I never even met you, but I love you. I want you to know that. Like, I feel y'all pain. I'm very sorry. I'm definitely not gonna stop fighting. As long as y'all gonna fight, I'm definitely gonna fight with you. Oh no. Oh yeah.
That's a lot of kids. And it's not about the color of your skin. You hear, oh, well, you sound this way, you sound that way. Mm-hmm. It's not about what you sound like. It's about your environment. You know?
Yeah.
But it's a lot of things that could change.
Yeah. Well, I definitely thank you for talking to me. Geez, people are saying this is so disgusting that he did this. Like, people are commenting right now, sending you a lot of love from around the world. So, oh shit. I mean, it's not too much to say. It's just really messed up, and it shouldn't happen. And justice needs to prevail. You know what I mean? And I'm glad to see people like galvanizing to try to make sure that happens, or at least do their damnedest to make it happen to the best of their ability, you know what I mean?
I mean, you have enough evidence. What more do you need? You have witnesses. You have autopsy. What else do you need?
Yeah.
And every time you take one thing to try to justify why he was shot,
right. Well, my thing is that
nobody deserves to die. He was not. No child deserves to die. No person.
Right. I'm like, it kills me that we are sitting over here talking about, we just want you to charge him. Well, what we all know he did. It's not even a disputable fact. Like, we just charge him.
You know what? I grew up as a kid. We were told to respect our elders. We were told to respect the police. A lot of that should go both ways. You respect those that respect you is what I was told.
That's what I was raised with.
I teach my children that. But should I teach my kids to be police officers? You know, my children's grandfather is an ex-police officer. They have two uncles and a son. I'm not saying all cops are bad cops. All politicians. They're not good politicians. It doesn't have to do with just cops. It's this economy a lot.
Yeah.
You know, we'll treat everybody the same and you won't have a problem. You won't have a problem.
Right, because we're all human.
Whether their upbringing is not good in your eyes, because you shouldn't be judging them.
Exactly.
God only judge. You don't make the judgment. You allow the law to prevail and let that be
good. What's your name, ma'am? I'm sorry.
Melva.
Nice, Melva. I'm Bella. Everybody calls me Bella. It's nice to meet you, too.
Thank you.
No problem. I just thank y'all for standing strong and just not taking it. Because you know what I mean? If y'all had been another family, just rolled over and didn't nobody get upset about nothing, I wouldn't have nothing to support. I'd be feeling isolated and alone with the same issues on the other
really
side. You know what I mean?
People that care in this world. I mean, it is really blessed. I truly care.
We do. We do. I mean, I can't speak for everybody, obviously, but I mean, I know a large number of people who really do, you know? So, I mean, it's unfortunate that he died. Out of it is coming a beautiful thing, and I really do hope it's a true catalyst for change. You know what I mean? At least that it won't seem so much in vain if something come from it that could be positive maybe for every black person in the world. You know what I mean? But we can all be treated like humans, because that's really all we want. You know, it's not a.
Don't judge me if I walk down the street.
Right.
Let me just walk down the street.
You know what I mean? So, I mean, and even then, it just seems like that even. It's not gonna do much because he's not gonna come back. You know what I mean? But at least it'll be something very positive forever written to history with his name. You know what I mean? And that. Something. I don't know. I don't even know what to call it because it just. Yeah, nothing as valuable as his life, you know what I mean? So it's just like, I don't even know what to call it. It's a good outcome. It's what we can look for, I guess, you know what I mean? But yeah, so I'm going to be here. I don't know if I'm going to try to go to the south side and see what their vigil looks like for a little bit later, but I definitely got to go check on my baby. I was like, ran out here and was like, oh, my Brown family. Let me make sure I try to talk to some people out here. Because everything right now that's happened is gonna be there for people to see. Whatever is being filmed by CNN and them, a 2-minute clip or something of that is gonna be there, and that's it. You know what I mean? And it's gonna be the clip that fits whatever narrative that they have, not the one that you're trying to tell. It's not gonna be your story. You know what I mean? So that's why I'm here.
Like I said, we raised our kids to be. That's what we did.
Yeah. No, this is his cousin. Her name is Melva. Oh, I'm sorry, you guys. I couldn't hear you that well. That's okay. When I upload the video, you guys can watch it again. Turn the volume up. Yeah, they're saying we need to rewrite police training and police policies, but it's not even that. It's the attitudinal inherency of society.
Right. It's what's been given from the beginning. It's not, it's gonna help when certain people get in office. But this is just local office. We need someone on top. And we need, you know what? I'm honestly going to say, it ain't even just the color of the skin that's in office. Do right by the people.
Exactly. Exactly.
I don't care about the color of someone's skin. If they serving to serve everyone, it ain't about the color of their skin. Just serve. If you're there to do a job, do the job.
Yeah, but now they're doing it.
You know?
Oh shit, this is a frustrating thing because it's like it's so much involved in it. It's not just a police shooting, you know what I mean? Like it's so much more than that.
Much more than that. And a lot of people wonder why the riots. You have people that have they tired. They are truly tired. And people have lived in poverty. And I work with a Caucasian woman, and she says the same thing that African Americans talk about, how they're profiled. Because she says, well, I'm poor white trash, you're not poor white trash. And you don't look at yourself. You shouldn't look at yourself in that way. They should treat you the same. But whatever's beneath them, I guess everybody can't be on top. Everybody can't live a good life.
Well, you know what? I was like, even if we all got paid the same amount of money, everybody, we would still need people to clean up the streets, to pick up our garbage, to make our pizzas. Like, don't look down on people for what they do. You know what I mean? Or it's just basically, you can't judge a book by its cover. You know what I mean? And so with that being such a popular statement in this country, it's very difficult to wrap my head around the fact that you judge people by the color of their skin. That's a book by its cover all day.
I'm a mother. I have three children, like I said, and one's in college. And I push her to finish.
Yeah.
You know, because if you can get as close to getting something good, you can get it. But don't forget, you know, I just pray. I just pray. I have a 14. My son is 14. And what people don't realize, trying to keep a young male focused on things, it's hard. It's hard for you. It's hard for me. But
I heard that interview.
He's doing it. I mean, he's doing it. He's changed his mindset. And I'm proud of him. So, but I'm just praying that my son gets to get to college.
Right.
That my son make it in this world. Because it's hard.
I just don't even... I just truly feel for y'all and what you're going through. And I can only imagine. It's a lot of the reason why I'm here. Is
it makes you scared. You know, I had a
by my son. You know what I mean?
It makes you scared. Like, my son comes from football practice. He normally gets on the bus. I'm screaming. I'm yelling. You didn't call me. You didn't tell me you were walking home.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want nobody stopping to say, I'm paranoid now. Because I'm afraid of what could happen to mine. Mike is mine. That's my family. But in the back of my head, don't walk home. Get on that bus that provided. Call me. And it's bad that you have to feel like you have to be over him and shield him like that from this craziness that's out here. You know? People ask me at my job, why are you guys protesting? Why not? I mean, why not protest?
Why wouldn't I? I'm happy the people at my job are much more understanding.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I lost a lot of Facebook friends after this, though.
Hey, Mama Kay, how you doing? I did. I'm good. How about you?
Awesome. When you got here?
Yesterday.
Oh, okay. You trying to be a good student in school.
I'm not. I heard I missed out on some cake.
Yeah, but you know what? I got some more at the house.
Good, because I'm going to be here for at least 2 weeks. So
what?
I need some cake.
You got the baby?
He has Subway. I'm about to go check on him. I'm just having to talk with the sister here.
Okay, I got my grandson with me.
Oakland.
Yeah. Back
no, that's why I'm like, oh, I'll see some Black Panther party here. You know, I feel at home a little bit. Yeah, no, you know, so I'm like, I'm from Oakland. So, you know, we deal with police oppression in Black communities in a ridiculous way. You know what I mean? When I left here... What was it? The 30th of September. I left here, went to Oakland for five days, came back. The day I left, the Oakland Police Department killed somebody before my plane landed. The day I got here yesterday, before my plane landed. San Francisco police killed a man from Oakland. You know what I mean? We still protesting about Alan Bluford, who Oakland Police Department killed. We still protesting about Oscar Grant. Then there's Ezell Ford and John Crawford, and you know what I mean? Like, it's just, it's like the list just continues to grow. And it, at such a rate, it's just ridiculous. You know what I mean? Like, it's not, and it is crazy because people are like, well, you guys are making this a race issue. It's like, no, we're not making it a race issue. It's a human issue. We're humans. But we're humans who happen to have a darker skin color, and so we're looked at differently. But when we say that, then, like, because we're making you uncomfortable with your thought process that you've been dealing with for the longest, like, now I'm a racist. You know what I mean?
My brother had talked to one of his school friends, and she told him, because she told him bye, she gave him a hug, and I went to a school, Hancock. Mm-hmm. Where I was told, this is when I was younger, going to school there, I was told that the parents are prejudiced. This is why the Caucasian parents are prejudiced. So. Oh my.
Okay.
But I mean, just to hear her thoughts and what she said to my brother, mm-hmm. proved to me what I felt. Couldn't go home and be friends with any of them. I mean, that hurts because I looked at myself as being him.
Right.
I remember being in high school when they passed Martin Luther King's holiday. Mm. And a guy in the class who stood up to this day. You hanging out with African American kids, but yet you say certain things out your mouth. I don't think that's cool.
Right.
They've been told they shouldn't. But this young lady in particular, she told my brother specifically when he hugged her, her father said, you better not ever touch another. I was like, I don't want to say word. Because my kids were told the N word was a bad word, mm-hmm. a blessing. So I'm so glad that someone, and this is something that my brother was saying on Facebook, we have so many Caucasian friends. Are you all truly friends?
Right.
What do you know for? I ask those questions. I try not to see color. My daughter dated outside her race because I try not to judge. I try not to discriminate. No racial issues with anyone. Why? He's human.
Right.
So, I mean, this is beautiful here. It's gonna change. It's gonna change.
Yeah.
And as long as to stay, what they say, through sweet snow, my bones be aching like it's cold out here. And I know I got a bad back and bad knees. They're cold, they're hitting me. But no matter what, you gotta be here.
Right.
Show the support. Get things done. Go vote. But we need to go higher than just our local office. We need to go. Congress needs to be out. We need to get state reps. These people been sitting in those offices for the longest.
And you know, if people are going to do this and by participating in the political process, you got to also realize that, like, number one is complete bullshit. But if, you know, if you are really going to try to affect change, like, you, the candidates that are given to you to choose from are oftentimes not the ones who are going to represent you. You know what I mean? So, like, you got to find people who, number one, will, like, not succumb to monetary or other types of pressure when in office and will be able to hold true to their morals. You know what I mean? In spite of the fact that oftentimes it's going to go against the success of the system that continues to oppress and profit off of, you know what I mean, people who are primarily black, but oftentimes anybody who just fits into the lower socioeconomic tax bracket. So it's like, you know, right here, I like this because it's like on the street, direct action, trying to affect change, like definitely drawing attention to the spectacle so that we can, like, our attention to the issue via spectacle so that we can, like, get people motivated enough to do what needs to be done politically. You know what I mean? Because it's like, that is a long, drawn-out process, and the passion that you have will be lost if you don't have this other end. You know what I mean? So it's like, you know, that's why I was like, the First Amendment is so important for protests to happen, because this is supposed to be a government by the people. And so people are supposed to be able to protest, so you can know if they have, you know what I mean? Like, if they are truly disagreeing with a government and not having their voices heard. And so, like, what's going on here with Mike Brown and Darren Wilson, and them keep, you know, descending on protesters with such excessive force, violating their constitutional rights. And if they're, you know, it just goes to show me, even with the National Guard coming down to restore peace, I'm like, well, what peace? The peace he was shot under? Like, I'm sorry, Obama, but when you sent them, you didn't. You know what I mean? And the very first words that you said when you addressed the public was that there's never a reason to fight against law enforcement. But in that statement, you lied. And as a matter of fact, as American citizens, it's actually our duty to hold them accountable up to using the Second Amendment, which means fighting against them. You know what I mean? So, like, when he's talking about it's never is, no, it very well is. You know what I mean? And while we keep trying to protest peacefully, but we're met with tanks and SWAT vehicles and police officers armed. You want us to be militant. You're giving the police militarized military weapons. They're going to war with American citizens. You know what I mean?
Like,
one plus two equals three. And then generationally, 4 years, we've always been contextualized as a threat. You know what I mean? So the very first people that they go to war with tend to be the black and the broke. And usually in that order, black, then broke. Like, the indigenous people, I do not mean to take anything from them, but, like, y'all genocide is damn near complete. Like,
and see, that's the point
you know
that
what I mean?
Was trying to bring to one of my workers. It's like, yeah, but still, if you put me and you in an office and we're trying to get, and I'm trying to get something, and you're trying to get the same thing that I'm trying to get, they may give it to you before, you know, maybe they're going to give it to you.
Exactly.
Give it to me.
Exactly.
Regardless of my educational background.
I know, it doesn't matter.
I mean, and it's not fair.
Hold on, especially if I'm not perming and flat ironing my hair and doing things to more be Eurocentric, to show that I have a desire to further assimilate into what it is that makes you comfortable and not be me. You know what I mean? So it's like, I appreciate when I come see people very proud to be black. You know what I mean? Like, no, I'm proud of my blackness.
I love this. Yeah,
thank
right.
you. You know what I mean? Like, I'm walking down the street, I'm proud to be black, because it is not a threat and it is not a crime, and I'm not an ignorant monkey, and I do have a job. You know what I mean? And I do take care of my child. And you know what I mean? And you don't need to think any of these things about me. As a matter of fact, welfare statistically is a white program. So don't look at me and think that I'm receiving welfare just because of the color of my skin as I walk down the street.
Amen.
Maybe I'm working two jobs in the same city I live in just to afford to live in this neighborhood. You know what I mean? Like, people don't understand that, and it's very evident when young black men, unarmed, walk down the street and get shot multiple times by police officers, on film, off film, you know what I mean? It's an issue. And even with Von Derrick last night, mm-hmm. 16, 17 shots, I don't give a damn. That's overkill. That is excessive. You want to tell me that it wasn't murder? He shot three shots at you, supposedly, didn't hit you once, but you was close enough to shoot him to the point to where you had to dig the bullets out the ground? And you want to tell me that you needed to have 17 shots and be reloading another clip?
There's no thing.
You see what I'm saying?
Cops' guns hold 16.
That's what I'm saying. No. But what I'm saying is, first of all, you were in your uniform, which means you are a public servant uniform, but you are working for a private security company. And then you did a pedestrian stop, which is damn near stop and frisk. What you stop him for? Because he was black? You see what I'm saying? You never made the reasons clear why you stopped him. Then you shot his ass to death, just over and over again. Then after you did that, you another Darren Wilson. Who the hell are you? Who your name? What's your name? Why do you even get to hide out like that? Because you were off duty, and you were hired by a private security company, which means you were just like any other citizen.
Exactly.
Make sure you have a purpose when you stopping somebody. And don't just go.
We got New Mexico, New Zealand, Canada. Everybody's like, we love you. We thinking about a positive. Please tell her we thinking about a positive. We are believing about a positive future for her children. People, I'm telling you. And these are comments that I can just see. And I can't always see all of them while I'm streaming. So.
One thing is, when they hide out a cop or kill a cop, that ain't nothing but a job well done.
Yeah, because you go paid vacation. So now what I want to know is, if he don't go to work as a police officer because he shot somebody while he was at work as a private contractor, do he get paid vacation?
So
do we pay for him to be off too?
So
you see what I'm saying? Like,
you,
but, You was impersonating an officer at that point in time. You were not an officer. You were off duty.
This is where our tax dollars go.
Yes.
To pay someone that killed an unknown. This is what our taxes go to. I need my taxes in my home today if this is where this is going to. Because I need to be able to feed my kids.
Exactly.
I need to be able to buy my kids what they need for sport activities and everything. This is what tax money goes to?
Right. It's, they say there's lots of people in shock.
St. Louis. They trying to build a new St. Louis. I already know what they did. They closed down all these schools in the city just so they could build up downtown.
Gentrification.
Because where did those tax dollars go? You know, they asked about Normandy, and I'm a Normandy alumni. Because they pulling good teachers out of the school. It was never a problem when we were being taught. So where's the tax dollars going? Going to people like Darren Wilson.
Right.
On vacation for killing unarmed kids.
Exactly. Okay, I keep saying I'm about to go check on my baby. I got to go check on my baby. But thank you very much for talking with me. I do appreciate it. I just want to extend my condolences again because it's just really unlimited, like the amount. I really do feel for y'all. I just wish that I could actually do something about it. This is the best I can do is try to get the word out.
I love the people.
Who the fuck is that guy right there?
This one right here?
No, in the pink shirt with the gray hoodie on. You see him behind the
I don't know, but he's been standing.
He's walking around scribbling stuff in his pad as he's watching and listening.
Well, what you want to go ask him?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. Well. Hello. Hi.
Oh, you with the Guardian. Okay,
hi.
Cool.
Hi,
what's
okay.
up? You with the Guardian.
Alright.
So what is the Guardian saying about everything? About this over here?
Well, we're just reporting it. And I mean,
because, you know, we don't really get the money in Guardian over here. Especially
you,
not in
you can get it online.
Yeah, we can get it online, but, you know, it's not really accessible to people like that. But, you know, so what are they saying now?
Well, now we're just coming back because you go this weekend. We were here before. I mean, mostly just reporting on what was happening.
Okay.
And I did a couple of opinion pieces.
And what is your name?
Gary? Gary Young.
Okay. Gary Young?
Yep.
What paper are you in? Is it?
The London Guardian.
Oh, the London Guardian. Oh, okay. Hey.
So you're from Ferguson?
Yeah.
So what would you like to say to people?
What would I like to say to people in London? Stand up for your rights. Stand up for yourself. Don't let police corruption go on. You know, don't tolerate it. You don't have to tolerate police brutality. You don't have to tolerate the things from your tyrannical government. Stand up for yourself. And that's what we're doing here. We're speaking out and we're standing up for something. This is a cause and we're in it for the long haul.
I was going to say, I think a lot of people will be surprised that you're still here.
Yeah. Yeah, because, I mean, incidents like this have a history of people having SMS, short memory syndrome. And no one expected the turnout to be ongoing. You know? But this is a systemic problem that we are combating. And in combat, you have to weather the times of war. And this is what we're doing. We're still out here until we get justice served. We're still out here. And we're going to continue to be out here until justice is served.
So I've got two more questions for you. The first is, how, and I'm talking organizationally, does this protest here respond to what just took place last night?
No, this is because of Mike Brown. What happened last night was just a coincidence, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it just so happened to happen. But we are unified here against police brutality. Mm-hmm. I mean, as a community as a whole, not just one isolated incident, because one isolated incident represents all of us. It could have been me, could have been you. So
what happened last night was just unfortunate. It was very unfortunate. And things like this, it's 61 days. It's been 61 days since Mike been killed. Why is this still going on?
I do want one thing. When you say that you're unified here, I keep getting told about the north side and the south side.
North side and the south side.
Right? Or whatever. I don't know. But I just know last night when people from here left to go down there in solidarity, there was nothing but love between the people. Now, people between police, I mean, you know.
That's a different story. Exactly.
But you didn't see any, you know.
Clashes.
Yeah, it was no clashes no like that of protesters. Like that. No.
Because everybody's been peaceful since day one. So now, when you bring military police and you bring a show of force with the police, of course you're going to antagonize and you're going to aggravate the protesters. Because you don't want to see that.
They want to have a reason to get you out of there violently.
Exactly. So now, when you guys are doing stuff like that, it's like you guys are purposely poking at the protesters.
Yeah.
You're stoking the flames.
And you're inciting a riot.
Exactly.
And then
exactly. So you guys can have justifiable cause to just go ahead and crack down and crack some heads and go on and arrest people. So now you have a story now. You have a story.
I just know that somebody in the UK is saying hello from the UK, solidarity, and The Guardian is not a bad news outlet. You
no,
may be
not.
Mainstream media, but you're not overly biased.
London Guardian breaks a lot of stories.
And that you covered the Snowden leaks very well.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that was our story. So, what happens if Wilson wins?
What happens? Well, I'm not Nostradamus, but I can tell you this. I don't really think it's going to be very peaceful.
I don't think it's going to be well received.
Exactly. It's not going to be well received at all. At all.
Why do you think they're taking so long?
Look at it. Geopolitical. This is a strategic move. This is an election year. A lot of guys are up for re-election. A lot of guys are trying to get elected. You don't want to do anything right now to jeopardize your election.
Not only that, do you think they're trying to just wait and see if maybe protesters will lose their steam?
Oh, no. People not going to lose. It's been 61 days. Election, what? Less than 30 days away?
Yeah.
It's been 60 already. People can wait, what, less than 30?
Can I have your name?
Adrian.
How old are you?
33.
Thanks very much.
Welcome.
Nice to meet you.
Thank
hey,
you.
Man.
Sorry.
Hey, you go back to London. Here. Take Piers Morgan with you. Please take that asshole, that arse.
That arsehole.
With you. Please take him with you. We don't want him over here.
There's a reason why he's here.
Yeah, there's a reason
why he's here. Because you guys didn't want him.
All right, John.
That phone tapping incident over there, but you know, that's another story.
All
right.
Thank you.
Okay, so no people are talking about Shaw about to blow up tonight, that it's hella people over there. I don't know. I think I'm about to stay here.
Think about it. It's going to be a city problem now. It's not just a county problem.
Yeah, but I'm about to shut down y'all and check my Twitter and check up and see what's happening on the other side. Go check on my baby because I keep saying I'm about to go do that and I haven't done that. AJ been over there babysitting me. Okay, so anyways, yeah, I'm going to shut down. I'm going to go check on my chargers. I'm going to get on Twitter and check the streams and see what's going on in the south side on Shaw. And then we're going to get in contact with some people and see what the general consensus is. But like, I don't want to take the camera off the people here because there's going to be massive shit going on in Shaw because people here still have things that they want to say. But let me, you know, make a plan of action and check on the baby and stuff. And I will bring the stream back up. Okay. Thank you.
He's still knocked out.
He's asleep? I know he's gonna go down. Ooh!
Y'all got separated from